So first off, we got the Ford Maverick. Not the new unibody truck thing, but the 1970 through 77 model. A underrated car for sure, but that's good for us because now we can get a good deal on them. Here's one I found for $1,500 that would make a pretty solid project. Originally came with a V8 too. And if you want something that's a little bit less of a project, I found one here for $6,000 that runs and drives. It has an inline six, but still a very nice car. Today we're going to be counting down the top 10 cheapest muscle cars, but we're only doing ones from the 60s and 70s, so it's got that classic muscle car styling to it. If you're new here, be sure to drop a like and subscribe, and with that out of the way, let's continue. Next on the list, we got the Dodge Aspen and Plymouth Valair. I put these two together because they're practically the same car. As for the styling, they both look very muscular, and their performance trims look even better. Price-wise, I found one for $2,500 that was someone's old rat rod but still runs and drives, and a super nice all-original Valair for around $12,000. Overall, if you're a Mopar guy, one of these might be the one for you. Up next, the Ford Falcon. So the word has gotten out that these are a cheap alternative to the classic Ford Mustang, and more people have been taking advantage of that and doing some cool builds with them. Here's the price for a roller. Obviously, it's pretty cheap because there's no engine. And here's one in drivable condition that, as you can see, is going to cost you twice as much. And because of these cars' growing popularity, you'll be able to get in touch with other owners for parts, advice on a problem you're having, and I'm sure they'd be happy to help. Next up is the one you've been waiting for, the Chevy Monte Carlo. At one point, the prices did go up pretty high on these, but as of now, they've gone down pretty low. Like the price for this one that was just pulled out of a barn, and this one here, in nicer condition, that used to be the seller's daily driver. A Monte Carlo was also used in a Fast and the Furious movie, and Craig Lieberman, the car designer at the time, explained that he used the Monte Carlo instead of a more recognizable muscle car because of its cheaper price, and that it just made more sense that a high schooler, like the one in the movie, would be able to afford one of these. So the Dodge Charger is next on the list, and before you start typing your comment about how the Dodge Charger is expensive, I'm referring to the 1971 through 74 model, or a B-body Charger, which is much cheaper than the earlier models. One of these in project condition is going to cost you a little bit more money than the last few cars. Around $5,000 seems to be the common price, and that could easily double for one that drives. But if you're trying to look like the Duke boys, this might be a good option for you. If I made a General Lee out of one of these, I would call it the Dollar General Lee because it's like a budget version. This is a good one for you Ford guys out there, the Ford Fairlane. These were super popular drag cars back in the day and even still will pull a lot of attention at car shows. Here's the price of a 1965. It looks in rough shape, but it does still run and drive. And a 1967 that has a V8 and a 4-speed for only $5,000. Now would be a good time to mention that I'm not leaving a link to any of the cars you see for sale here. I'm just using them in a way that give you guys a sense of the market. I try to show one in kind of like a rolling shell condition, and then like one in mid condition, so you can kind of see the price difference, and so you don't end up overpaying for someone else's junk. Next on the list is the 1973 and 74 Plymouth Roadrunner. It may not be the best style, but it's still a Roadrunner, so it's got some name recognition going for it. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, this one's a really good deal. A project Roadrunner's usually gonna cost about the same as the Chargers from earlier. And here's the price of one that's in nicer condition. Be sure you get the Roadrunner horn, because if you got a Roadrunner, you gotta have the horn. Now we got the Chevy Impala. This is a really good choice. Not only does it have very muscular styling, but it's also a Chevy, so an LS swap or just a small block Chevy build are great affordable options for the powertrain. There's also a great aftermarket on these, so other parts like body panels and stuff are plentiful. On the low side of the prices, we got one here that's pretty solid but does need a motor. Then there's quite a few of these with the Impalas where someone has put in some work, getting it running and driving, doing some body work and stuff like that. Prices on stuff like that are a pretty good deal and would probably be the route I'd take if I wanted an Impala. Alright, for this last one, I'm gonna need you to hear me out. What if I told you could get your favorite 60s muscle car in all original condition for a fraction of the price? What I'm talking about is the four-door market. I know a four-door car isn't exactly what comes to mind when you think of a muscle car, but once I show you the prices they're going for, you might start changing your mind. Just look at this Chevelle that sold for only $6,600. That's a pretty good deal considering the price a two-door would sell for. And this fair condition Plymouth, again, is a fraction of the price that a two-door would be. Shout out to that subscriber who owns a 68 Roadrunner. Thanks for your support, dude, and good luck with your project. Thank you all for watching. If you're new here, be sure to subscribe for more muscle car content. Also, if you enjoyed the video, be sure to press that like button. I'll see you guys later.